السميع العليم.
الحمد لله. الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره ونستعين به سبحانه وتعالى ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ به جل وعلا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. عباد الله، أنصحكم ونفسي الآثمة بتقوى الله، وأحثكم وإياها على طاعته، وأحذركم وإياها وبال مخالفته جل وعلا ومعصيته. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ولا شيء مثله، ولا شيء قبله، ولا شيء معه، قديم بلا ابتداء، دائم بلا انتهاء، لا يفنى ولا يبيد، ولا يكون إلا ما يريد، لا تبلغه الأوهام ولا تدركه الأفهام ولا يشبه الأنام، حي لا يموت، قيوم لا ينام. وأشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا وحبيبنا وعظيمنا وسيدنا وقرة أعيننا ونور أبصارنا وبصائرنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. صل اللهم على نور الورى وبدر الدجى وشمس الضحى ونور العلا، أعني الحبيب محمدا المصطفى، وصلي على آله سادة الأنام وحماة بيضة الإسلام، موضحي حقائق الدين وقاهري أحزاب المفسدين وسهام من مرام الله على المنافقين. ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن صحابة رسول الله المخلصين المحسنين المتقين، لا سيما الخلفاء الراشدون ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وعن سائر الصحابة والتابعين ومن اتبعهم بإحسان وتمسك بالثقلين إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، قال الله جل وعلا: ولا تحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله أموات بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون. The ayah has come in many different ways, many different forms في القرآن العظيم. And the ayah, the rough meaning of the ayah is, or the general meaning of the ayah is, don't think that those who died in the path of Allah, the martyrs, the shaheed, don't think that they have died. Indeed, they are alive. Al-Quran says, Ahya. Ahya means life, and usually this description is only given to someone who's actually walking, talking, and eating, and breathing between us. Al-Quran says this about the shuhada, the shaheed, and emphasizes that they are ahya. But you don't know. Not only that, فَرِحِينَ بِمَا أَتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. They are actually very pleased by what they are seeing. From this ayah we conclude something. That the real birth certificate of a shaheed is given to him or her upon their martyrdom. When they die in the path of Allah, that's when their birth certificate is issued for them. That's when they are actually born, and then they live for a very, very long time. We are still with Imam Abi Abdullah al-Husayn, and we are still with all these things that went through. And what kind of lessons can we get through? The Shahada of Imam al-Husayn, what can we understand from that? We talked about what happened. Now we have to understand a few things. Why is Imam al-Husayn still talked about 1365 years after his martyrdom, after his Shahada? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed for the shaheed to live. And there's a secret, there's a secret in this lasting memory of Imam al-Husayn, subhanAllah. And it almost is very unique to al-Husayn himself. And I will say few things. The reason for that, there are efforts to alienate al-Husayn, to put him out of the picture. And these efforts are serious. Despite all these efforts that have been pounding years after years for more than 1,000 years, subhanAllah, you still see the people of Haqq are still looking at Al-Husayn as the light, the nur that came, the nur that was a continuation of the nur of his grandfather sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Despite all these attempts and all these efforts and all these concrete words to alienate Al-Husayn and to put him out of the picture. Let me just go through a few efforts that have been made and are still. The reason we say that, and the reason I say that, and the reason we cover this, is because there are lessons for us to learn. In Islam, we don't believe anything in history or anything should be hidden. We don't have secret agendas, in other words. And Quran was Sunnah is wide open for everybody. Islam doesn't have things that they should know and they shouldn't know. Islam gives you everything that everyone should know and learn from. Al-Qur'an al-Azim is open. Everybody learn and read and understand. Of course, having the ability to learn and read and understand. The tools to learn, read and understand. Among these things, of course, he suffered a lot. And suffering, and I don't mean by suffering only physically, he suffered that, we already talked about in the Waqi'ah. But he suffered more than that. The mere mentioning of Hussein creates waves. Imam Hassan ibn Hussein, you mentioned their name, creates waves already. It tells you the effect of all these efforts are still very much present and still very much affect our thinking and affect how we decide. First, among the things, they tried to alienate him from his grandfather, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In an attempt to separate between Al-Husayn wa al-Nabiyul A'zam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what did they say first? They said, well, wait a minute. You say Al-Husayn, but Al-Husayn is son of a daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's not the son of Rasulullah. So why do you keep saying the son of Rasulullah? He's the son of the daughter of Rasulullah, and that's usually not directly your son. Attempts are what? So again, it's not the attempt to genealogy or genealogically kind of analyze the situation, no. It's an attempt to alienate him, to spread him away from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the whole thing is al-hadith, rawah al-hakim, wa huwa sahih. When the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Hassan wa Hussein ibnai, they are my sons. More than that, al-Bukhari narrates in his sahih about Imam Hassan, al-Hasanu inna ibni hadha sayyid. My son? He didn't say my grandson, he said my son. And this was an attempt throughout the Umayyad rules and the Abbasi rules, of course, and those who continue on that same pathway. I'll give you an example of what happened with Harun al-Rashid with Imam Musa al-Kadhim. Imam Musa bin Ja'far, of course, as you all know, the Abbasis were more brutal with the offspring of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam than the Umayyads. And it did not stop. Don't think that it's just stopped there. No, no, no. It didn't stop. It was a continuation. Still, to a little extent. The Abbasis, of course, by doing all these things, he brought Musa as the son of Ja'far, the son of Muhammad, the son of Zain al-Abidin, son of Hussein, son of Ali ibn Talib and Fatima. He told them, why are you claiming Harun? He's telling him, you're claiming that you are the son of Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and your grandfather, grand-grandfather is only what? He's only what? He is a son of a daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So why are you claiming this? He said, Ya Harun, imagine this. If the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was to be resurrected today, come out of his grave.